They say that if you go to appsmith.com, log in, then create a new application, then go to data, create a new data source, scroll and select Appsmith AI, give it a name, save it, then find and drag a file picker widget, then create a new query, select the AI data source, give it a name, select extract entities from image, then bind the file picker field and define the entities you want Appsmith AI to extract from the image. Then drag and drop a table widget and image widget and bind the file picker. Then on the file picker select event, select the Appsmith AI query, then deploy the app, select and upload an image, and done. Appsmith AI will analyze and extract the entities you defined from the images. But if that was too fast for you, then stay and I'll explain all the details on how to achieve this and more using Appsmith AI image classification, entity extraction, labeling, and much more. All right, here I am in Appsmith, and let me create a new app to explain everything to you. The first thing is, let's go to the data section and create a new data source. Let's scroll down and find Appsmith AI under the AI integrations. Now, you don't need to upload any files. This is normally for generating context. In case you missed it, there is another video about generating context and how you can give Appsmith AI the files you wanted to learn about, and then you can ask questions. So take a look at that playlist. So let's give it a name. I'm just gonna call it AI. I'm not going to upload any files again, and that's all we need. Now we're ready to create our query against this data source. But before we do that, let's find the file picker and drag and drop into the canvas. This is a mechanism that people can upload their files, it could be images, PDFs, what have you, to Appsmith, and then we can manipulate those images, files, etc. in the way we want. Normally for images, Appsmith can manipulate them as files or base64, etc. So now that we have that, let's create a new query and select Appsmith AI as the data source. We can give it a name. I'm going to call it just image for now. And let's find the extract entities from image. This is going to allow to scan the image, analyze the image by Appsmith AI, and extract the entities we wanted from that specific image. So the first question is going to be what the input is going to be. Now, this is where the image in this case, the image is going to be sourced to Appsmith AI. So in this case, I'm going to be using the file picker, which just drag and drop into the canvas. In this case, the name is file picker one, and then you can access the array of files because we can upload multiple files to this file picker. So normally that's an array. But in this case, I'm going to be in the future just uploading one single image. So normally we access the first item in that array, and then we access the data property. That's going to be retrieving the base64 encoding image of the file upload. And that's exactly what the input for this specific data source is requesting. As you can see, provide an image URL or a base64 encoded image. So that's great. Now, what do we want to extract from the images? In my case, I want the name because I'm going to be scanning, in this case, identification files like passports, driving license, student ID, etc. So I'm going to be requesting for the name, the date of birth, the gender, license number, the height, and the address. Now, the cool stuff is that if some of the properties or entities we're asking Appsmith AI to analyze are not present, this is not going to fail. It's just going to try to find the ones we're telling. But if there's no present, in this case, for example, we upload a passport, the height is normally not in the passport or the address or the license number. So in this case, it's not going to give any data in return, but for other images, it will. So it's not going to fail. And then also we can provide some additional instructions for the AI to tweak the entity extraction. For now, I'm not going to give it any specific tweak or anything. So let's just save it for now. Let's keep it like that. It's throwing an error because we haven't uploaded any image to the file picker. So let's go back to the UI and let's drag and drop in a table. In this table, we're going to be using it to see the image extraction values. Then we can use that, for example, to save to a database, send to a data warehousing, etc. You can do anything right after Appsmith analyzes the image. But for me, it's just going to be showcasing that information in the table widget. And let me find also an image, because that way we can easily see what we uploaded in the file picker. So I'm just going to be putting the image here, the table here. And we're going to be referencing in this image the file picker, that files, again, in the zero position and the data. So now if I try to upload a file, let me find a file here. For example, I should have a driver license around here. Upload that file. And now we can preview that image here. And if we go back to our query, now we can see that there's actually data in the Base64 encoded field that we're passing as the input. So we could actually run it here. And Appsmith AI will analyze the image and extract the entities from it. And there you go. If we make this bigger, we can see that it retrieves the name, date of birth, gender, license number, and height, and also the address, which is great. Now, as you can see, the structure of this response is a object, and inside it, each object, there is a property with each of the labels that Appsmith AI found. For example, the name, date of birth, gender. But if you, these properties are actually an array. And why? Because Appsmith AI could find multiple instances of this label in one single image. What happens is, for example, in what you're requesting Appsmith AI to analyze, there are multiple license numbers or multiple addresses. So that's the reason why each of the values are represented as an array. Now, this data structure doesn't really work for a table widget within Appsmith, because normally what we're expecting is just an array of objects, and inside the object we just have the value of each field. So we have to write a very simple JavaScript object that abstract that information and retrieve it as an object. So let's just create a new JavaScript object. We can leave it as it is, the name, or you can put any name you want. And now all I'm going to do is just paste a very simple function here, which is called extract entities, that is going to be accessing each of the keys from the image. Remember, that's the name we gave it, the query, that data, that response. And then it's going to extract the values of each of the responses keys in that object. And then it's going to iterate throughout the data using a map function, and it will retrieve a new object with the structure that the table requires. It's just flattering the data, basically. So now what we could do is go back to the UI, and in the table, we're going to be connecting the data using JavaScript. Actually, I'm not going to be selecting this dropdown. Let's enable the JavaScript mode and use the JSON object. Remember, we just leave it the name that it had, JSON object one, that the name of the property, which is table data. And then inside of the function, we're going to be updating that value table data with the response from the Appsmith AI app. Image analysis. So now one last thing we have to do is bind these actions to the file upload event. So let's click on the file picker, and if we scroll down, we will see the event section. On file selected is going to be whatever we want to trigger when somebody uploads a file using the file picker. So the first thing we're going to be doing is executing a query, in this case the image query. So great, that's going to be analyzing the image and retrieving the response. But now we wanted to display it on the table. And remember, we are using JavaScript to manipulate the data from Appsmith AI image entity extraction to flatten the data and put it on a structure that the table widget supports. So what I'm going to be doing is attaching another action, or actually when the image.run query finishes, let's call another function, and let's call the JSON object extract entities function. So that function is going to execute, extract the values, update the JSON.table widget, or in this case, the table data, sorry, and we should be able to see the response on the table widget. So let's actually deploy it. As you can see, we don't have anything. Let's select our file. Let's find for our driver license here. Upload that driver license, and once that happens, as you can see, the actions that we bind to the file upload are being triggered. The first thing is calling Appsmith AI image extraction, and second, updating the table information that is feeding the JSON object. And as you can see, we can see right now the name from the license, the date of birth, the gender, license number, height, and address. So that's great. This is working perfectly. Now, let me give you one last example that actually works with what we just built. Let's create a new query. And again, let's select the data source that we are using. And let's use the classify image option or action. So in this project, people might upload, like I said, driver licenses, passports, student IDs, and other types of identification. So I want Appsmith AI that not only extract the entities, but also tell me what type of document we uploaded to the file picker. So the input again is going to be the same one, the file picker, that files in the zero position, that data. And now the labels that we want Appsmith AI to classify for this image. I want to find if it is a passport, if it is a driver license, a student ID, and that's it. That's the type of files that we might be uploading to this query. And let's give it a name, image classify. So now let's go back to the UI. Let's bring a text field next to this, and let's bind it to the image classify that data, and then that normally has a response object. Response. There you go. So right now it's throwing an error because we don't really have anything in the query retrieved yet. Let's also go to the settings and remove the wrong query on page load option, because we're going to be actually triggering this again on the file picker. So let's go to the file picker options and add another action, execute the image classify. So now we have two actions when somebody uploads a file, the image entity extraction and the image classification. And also one thing we could do is here, we could use an or statement and just show something like upload an image to scan. So that way we don't have anything, which is going to show that in the text field. Right, let's deploy once again. Select our files. Find, not for the driver license, actually have a passport here. Upload the passport and let's see if it actually works. So the image extraction worked pretty well. In this case, this passport doesn't have really a height or an address, because that information is not really on the passport. And as you can see on the text field, Appsmith image classification is retrieving that this is a passport. Now it seems that we have to extract the value from the array. We're going to do that just in a second, but let's actually try another file. Let's find for a, let me see if I have it. There you go. This is a student ID. This is not a passport. It's not a driving license. It's a student ID. And as you can see now, it identifies as a student identification and it's extracting the information that it could find from that image. As you can see, we don't have a driving license number because that's not part of a student identification. Also not the height or the gender. That's not part of this image, but the name, date of the birth, and the address are correctly being extracted and identified as a student identification. So let's just go back and make some final tweaks in here. Let's find for the text field. And what I'm going to do is put here the type label. And again, read the response zero position, because as you could see, is an array. That response in the zero position. We have another passport here. Let's give it a shot to this passport. This is a passport from someone from Iceland. And it worked. It gives us that the type is a passport, and we can see the name here, which is kind of hard to read. Date of the birth, gender, license number, or in this case, it shouldn't be license number. It should be like the actual passport number. The height is actually present in this passport, but not the address. So that's it. This is how easy you can use Appsmith AI to analyze and extract entities and classify images on your Appsmith application. Now, you just witnessed how easy it is to take your internal business apps to another level using Appsmith AI. Remember to subscribe to our channel, join us in Discord, the community portal, and let us know in the comments if you have any questions. See you on the next one.